in that immense shed. What's he up for? See you, Samuel. Where did he go up? And his seat or his throne of authority, that is God, it extends over the heavens and the earth. And you know, I have to read this verse to you, because man comes into material might, military might. He got bombs, he got drones, he got airplanes, he got rocket ships, he got missiles, and he thinks that he controls the earth. With all his power, all that military power, you know what I say to those men? I don't care if they're United States or Russia. You know what I tell them? Stop this hurricane that's on its way now. You got so much power, stop it. Lord, Allah sends these things as signs to let you know who is the powerful one. Because we deceive ourselves. We get lost because we drop bombs here and drop bombs there and a missile here and a missile there. And Allah just sent one of his little bitty soldiers called Matthew, the hurricane, and sent everybody running, the military and all. That deal. Oh, you should have heard the people praying. Oh man, atheists started praying. Oh God, please. Okay. Why? A little breath of wind, a sneeze in nature. Just a sneeze. Everybody running on their fours, like an animal on all fours. Lord, what? I'm not making my for anybody. I'm on my fours too. Yes, I fear Allah. And it says, well, man. And it says, and Allah has no fatigue. He does not get tired in protecting the heavens and earth. Look at me. I want you to watch me. How many of you, you see this here? You see this little light thing here? How long can you take your hand and hold this out like this? Or a glass of water? I'm talking about you, got thick muscles on your eyebrows. How long can you hold your hand out like this? As a matter of fact, I'll take this away. How long can you hold your arms out like this? Not long. In time, your arms are going to come down because you don't have the strength to hold even your own arms up. Well, Allah holds up the heavens and the earth and the entire universe. And universe is. And he never experiences fatigue. That's the God we believe in. You cannot take him and crucify him. You cannot take God and he is born. God is not born. He can't be born. He's too big to be born into a small womb of a woman. Allahu Akbar. This is why Islam had to come back. Because no prophet had that kind of teaching. None of the prophets had that teaching. And if they've had that teaching, I'm asking, they're on the internet right now, please show me the prophets that have had the teaching that there was three gods. Please show it to me in the Bible somewhere. It does not exist. So El Islam has to come to restore the faith tradition back to what it was in the beginning. Allah. Thank Allah the Almighty. And I pray Allah that you can appreciate the struggle. Please don't be scared because I raised my voice. There are some people that can't hear unless I talk real loud. No, I mean they got a hearing problem, for real. I'm not making mockery. Some people, they have hearing problems, so we have to help them. Excuse me. So in our religion it says, La ilaha illallah, there is no God but one, and Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the last. He's Allah's messenger, but he's the last prophet. No prophet to come after him. And I've heard people that say, yeah, there's a prophet coming after them. No, it's not. You had the rukuma, you had the rukumullahu nafsahu. Translate. It means Allah portions you, all of you, through his soul. That's chapter 3 of the Quran. The young man, he's visited with us, he's new. And I told him, let him write notes. You can take notes. If you can't get them fast enough, we have a CD. You get the CD. You don't have no money, you get the CD for free. That's for any of you. It's more important that you get the message, the concept. That's what's most important. Not how much money you make off. Let me make some money. The only thing they're gonna do is pay like you. I'm not on salary. Nobody give me money to talk like this. I've been here talking like this for almost 18 years now, maybe 19. I haven't gotten a salary yet. Every now and then they'll buy me a sandwich. And I'm thankful. Sister, they make sure I get something downstairs. Sister Amina, here, buddy, ma'am, she'll give you something, you know what I mean? And I'll be rolling with you. You know what Allah says about you? God, he says this about you. Who al-ladhi? It is he alone. Al-ladhi? Al-ladhi is not al-ladhani. Al-ladhani, al-ladhani would be two. It didn't say that. Al-ladhina will be thalatha wa kathira. Which means that if I say al-ladhina, it'd be three or more. But God, he says here, who al-ladhi? It is he, one. And sha'a lakum as-sama'a wal-absar wal... Help me. Leave them alone, alhamdulillah. They got the spirit. Well, af-idata. I hope I said that right. Arabic is not my mother tongue. Translate. It says that he Allah alone, one being, look, he made for you and sha'a, he produced lakum for all of you. See, all of you. And for the poor people, the poor African Americans, so-called third world countries, you really need to listen to this. It says lakum. You see Bill Gates, you see Donald Trump, and you look over like this here. They got eyes and ears, right? Just like you. This is where the Quran comes as important. Do not make another man more important to you in your mind where you see yourself as inferior. That's a sin in Islam, for you to see yourself as inferior to another man or another race. Allah Akbar. Allah Akbar. So I'm greeting to you, this is the Quran says, and sha'a lakum sam'a. He made for you the hearing. Well, the sorrow and the insight. Then it said, Qaleelan, little man, tashkuruna, little it is that you give thanks for the hearing that you have, and the eyes that you have, and the attention to it. How many of us say, oh Allah, thank you for my eyes? How many of us say that? Very few of us. Thank you for my hearing. You see? Now let me say this to you to help someone. You see your eye? If you look on your body part, excuse me, I'm not being disrespectful, there's Christians here, so I'm helping them. God made it that the highest thing in your body is your eye, see? Then the next level height is your ear. Can you see what I'm showing you? Then the next level height is your nose. Then the next level height is your taste. And the only thing that goes all throughout your body is your feelings. But feelings is trying to see. God, I don't know if you understand what I'm telling you. A blind man, he does like this. Why he do like this? Because he's trying to see with his feeling. Am I making it clear? You come up, the next one you have is your tongue. Look, your tongue. And you want to taste something. You know, most of the time you won't just drink it all right. I'm giving the wisdom of your Quran. You won't drink it all right. You taste it a little bit to see if it's safe for you, don't you? You take a little sip. And if not that, you spit it out. Allah gave you that power of discrimination. And most men lose what I just demonstrated to you and become alcoholics. When they first took alcohol, they spit it out. Why? Because the senses, your five senses have limitation, but your five senses do not have imperfections. I want to say that to you again. Your five senses have limitation, but they are not imperfect. Your five senses have limitations, but your five senses are perfect. So the first time the person drinks alcohol, he spit it out. Because the tongue has the power by Allah to discriminate what is good for the body and not. Alhamdulillah. I'm giving you a Quran truth. 1,400 years ago, next one is the nose, right? Next thing you go and you go to smell your food. You smell it. It don't smell right. Then you won't eat it. Another protection Allah gave you. Right here. Then the next thing is this right here. Your ear. Your ear. Now I'm going to tell you this. Although the eye is the highest part in the body, it's not the first that you operate with. The first that the human being operates is his hearing. The human being can hear before he can see and focus. I'm saying this to you. When you were a small baby, you could not see, but you could hear accurately. You may say, oh, I don't see why that's important. You ever notice if somebody says something real important, what do you do? Don't you bend your ear like this? Yeah. Unless I'm talking a bunch of angels in here that don't have ears. And you'll turn it like this here. And if it's even more important than that, you'll take your hand and put it up like this. Am I right or wrong? And if it's very important, you take two hands and put it up. You see? Now, what is Allah demonstrating in here for you? You think it's just to hear? As I told you, the hearing on the outside, that's not the most important. The ear not only hears, listen to me, especially you mothers and women who intend to have babies. God has made the human ear to be the balancing point for you. You see, I stand up straight like this because my inside ear is healthy. If my inside ear becomes unhealthy as any woman, I will start staggering and you'll think that I have been smoking reefer or drinking alcohol. That's how important your ears are. If you take a cat, you know what a cat is? A kitten even. And you take a kitten and you turn him upside down, hold him by his feet. Please do this for me. And then come back and tell me I told you the truth or I lied to you. Take the cat and hold him upside down and let that cat go. He's automatically going to land on his feet every time. Take me. I don't know if you understand what I just told you. The cat, no matter how old it is, take it upside down by its feet and let it go, and it will land on its feet, which means that the inner ear has the ability to know when you are in balance and when you are out of balance, your ear. This is why in the van you go Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. You don't go like this with your eyes. You go like this on your ear. Because Muhammad the Prophet was given a revelation that man hears first before he sees. And most of you, if I give you a complicated term in mathematics, I'm talking about a big complicated term in mathematics, you will hear what I'm telling you, but you will not be able to see the answer. You can hear the problem, but you can't see the answer. The answer comes later. So Allah told us that when he created the human being's hearing is in place before his vision. Allah. And anywhere you read in the Quran, it'll say As-Sama, and then it says, well, Absar. As-Sama is always first, and Absar is later. Allah made you the creature to be able to hear the truth before you can even see it. Special creation, who you are. Allah. Then Allah says to us in the Quran, says, وَالنَّفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا. What? Nafsin and the, it's a soul. It's not the soul. It didn't say, وَالنَّفْسِ. No. It says, وَالنَّفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا. And I'm talking to you people here. Nafsin means, in Arabic, when you have a noun, nafs is a soul, it's a noun, person, place, thing. I'm speaking to the Arabic students in here too. If you say an-nafsi, then that's a specific soul, one soul, death. But if you say nafsin, you mean any soul. Are you listening to this? I'm showing you your Quran, how it speaks to your dignity. It says, wa nafsin wa ma sawwaha. And it means that any soul, male, female, old, black, white, all of them have the same perfection. Oh my goodness. There's some big dude trying to run for the president of the United States and trying to exclude some people and let others in. Y'all know what I'm talking about, fill in the blanks. He certainly needs the help from the Quran. Well, the Quran says, and every soul has its perfection. Point to America, to a Mexican, he got a perfected soul. Point to a Syrian, perfected soul. Point to any nationality, according to this Quran. See, maybe your book ain't strong enough to take that stand. But this Quran is strong enough to say that all people all the same. Look what friend Danny Adam. And we have made most honorable all of the children of Adam. Who's saying this? The Quran? This is why the Quran had to come, because it would not allow that racism and inequality be established in religion. So it's here. And we go to our sources. Anything that I might say, anything that anybody says, if I have a question about it, I go to El Quran Kareem. And it's going to get me the answer. And I'm telling you that everybody else has failed. All other religious leaders should be as loud as I am in declaring the oneness of humanity, if they truly follow Moses, if they truly follow Christ Jesus, and certainly for Muslims, if they follow Muhammad the Prophet. This is no plaything. This is no joke. You might not like me, but you better like the message. You understand what I'm saying? I don't care if you like me or not. That's the heck of that. But you need to fall in love with truth. Then I get somebody up here who's a little more handsome. I got a young man right there. All the women like him. So maybe I'll let him speak more. Boy, they like him. He's handsome. He's handsome. But he's more handsome in his heart than he is on outside. He is. He does a lot of wonderful work. Same thing with my young man here, Wally. I've known him. See, he's sitting there with his baby daughter and baby son. I remember when he was that small. And my other brother, Mikhail's son, he's sitting with his grandson. I remember when they were all that little. You see? Oh, Lord. So you have to have a message for them, a message for their children. Don't be looking at me. The heck with Nasser. What you're concerned is, what is Nasser saying? Is what he's saying the truth? Is it rational? Is it right? Did Muhammad say? Did Allah say? Is it good for my children? Get out of this personality, foolishness. And align yourself with the message.